Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 29th of June. Security tightened around vital installations in India's Jammu and Kashmir after drone attack. Activists highlight Pakistani atrocities in Balochistan through photo exhibition in Geneva. And crowds flee Dhaka ahead of strict coronavirus lockdown in Bangladesh. And now for all the details. Top cop of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory on Tuesday said that security has been strengthened around vital installations across Kashmir Valley in view of the threat posed by possible drone attacks. This comes days after Indian Air Force station located at the Jammu airport was attacked with two explosives-laden drones. The blast have caused concern in security circles as they could mark the first time that drones have been used in an attack in India.
Security has been strengthened around vital installations across India's Jammu and Kashmir in view of the threat posed by possible drone attacks. Vijay Kumar, the Inspector General of Police Kashmir Zone, said on Tuesday. This comes after two explosive-laden drones had crashed into the high-security Indian Air Force station at the Jammu airport on Sunday. After the terror attack, two separate drone activities were thwarted at Jammu's Ratnuchak-Kaluchak military station. More suspected drone activity was recorded in Kunjuwani late Monday night. India's Counter-Terrorist Task Force, NIA, National Investigation Agency, was on Tuesday given the charge of investigation into the attack. Kumar also revealed that a drone was spotted over Dal Lake on Tuesday.
15 crore mein Joshi, 15 crore corps commander saab ne meeting liye, maine attend kiya. Further usko strengthen log kar rahe hain. Jitne vital installation hai isko bhi plus LC par bhi. Uske alawa aaj dekhe honge jaisa ek Dal ke area mein ek drone fly kar raha tha, usko police ne jabt kar liya, FIR lodge kiya, usme karwai kar rahe hain hum log.
India on Monday at the United Nations raised the issue of terrorist groups using drones to attack vital strategic installations. India expressed concern over misuse of information and communication technology for terrorist propaganda and radicalization and called on the attention of the UN member states on the possibility of weaponized drones for terrorist purposes. India said that international community should call upon Pakistan to take effective, verifiable and irreversible actions against terror outfits operating on its territory.
India's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan on Tuesday warned the second wave of the coronavirus in the country is not over yet and he urged people to not let the guards down and follow COVID-appropriate behavior. His statement came as crowds have spilled onto streets and marketplaces as authorities in several states have eased restrictions, threatening another spike in infections. India's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan on Tuesday asked Indians to exercise COVID-appropriate behavior and not let the guards down as he warned the second wave of the coronavirus is not over yet, while urging people to get vaccinated. Authorities in several Indian states, including capital New Delhi, have eased restrictions amid a decline in daily COVID-19 cases, triggering crowds onto the streets and marketplaces and threatening another spike in infections. India on Tuesday reported 37,566 new COVID-19 infections, the lowest daily in last 102 days, taking the cases tally to 30.31 million with 397,637 deaths so far.
जो वेव है हमारा जो सेकंड फेज था कोविड का जिसको हम सेकंड वेव के नाम से अब ज्यादा जो है चर्चा करने लगे हैं ये समाप्त नहीं हुआ है और अभी भी इतने केसेस देश भर में हो रहे हैं हमारे दिल्ली में निश्चित रूप से केसेस के अंदर बहुत भारी कमी आई है लेकिन जो 1.5 वर्ष का अनुभव हमारे को बताता है कि हमें किसी भी परिस्थिति में रिलैक्स नहीं होना है।
Meanwhile, India's Maharashtra state, home to financial capital of Mumbai, has ordered malls and cinema halls to close amid mounting concerns of Delta Plus variant. Maharashtra was the worst hit by the devastating second wave in April and May and is still reporting a quarter of all new cases nationwide. At least 20 cases of the new variant have been reported from across the state.
In news from Pakistan, weeks after Pakistan's foreign minister denied claims that there are any safe haven for the Taliban in his country, Pakistan's interior minister Sheikh Rashid Ahmed has said families of Afghan Taliban live in his country, including in the capital city of Islamabad.
Amid continued escalation of violence by the Taliban in Afghanistan, Pakistan's Interior Minister Sheikh Rashid Ahmed has admitted that families of Afghan Taliban reside in his country, including in the capital city of Islamabad. Rashid, during an interview with Jio News on Sunday, also said that Taliban receive medical treatment in Pakistani hospitals. This comes as Afghanistan has witnessed a surge in violence in the past few weeks due to the Taliban offensive, following US President Joe Biden's announcement in April of the withdrawal of American forces from the country by September 11 after nearly 20 years of conflict. Earlier this month, Pakistan's Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi, in an exclusive interview to Tolo News, had denied the presence of Taliban sanctuaries in Pakistan. Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan, in a recent op-ed published by the Washington Post, said that his country opposes any military takeover of Afghanistan and that the Taliban cannot win over the whole of the country and yet must be included in any government for it to succeed. Pakistan has long been accused of harboring leaders and fighters of the Taliban, whom Islamabad helped to power in 1996, even as the insurgent group fought US-led foreign troops. Meanwhile, Taliban militants have taken over a district, launched attacks on checkpoints and cemented control over a border trade crossing, officials said on Monday, as clashes intensify in Afghanistan's central and northern provinces.
Moving on, activists have been highlighting persecution of innocent Baloch people by the Pakistani state and its army through a photo exhibition outside the UNHRC building in Geneva. President of Baloch Voice Association Munir Mengel, while raising concern over the rising cases of enforced disappearances, blamed that there is worst kind of subjugation in Balochistan.
Baloch activists have been highlighting persecution of Baloch people by Pakistan through a photo exhibition outside the building of the UN Human Rights Council in Geneva. Munir Mengel, president of Baloch Voice Association France, said that in Balochistan there is worst kind of subjugation, as he raised concern over enforced disappearances and extrajudicial killings of thousands of Baloch people by Pakistani security forces over the past several years. He urged the United Nations to intervene to stop the ongoing genocide.
Forces are taking the people and then there's a no whereabout of those people. Neither they are presented to any court of justice, nor their even family members. They do not know where are they and what they have done, for what they have been disappeared by force. And this is an activity which the Pakistani forces have been doing it from many years.
Activists blame there has been a sharp rise in human rights violations in Balochistan since the launch of the multi-billion China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, or CPEC, which has only brought death and destruction for the local people instead of economic opportunities. They accuse Pakistani security forces have been given a free hand to eliminate voices against the illegal project.
In news from Bangladesh, thousands of people, mainly migrant workers, on Monday rushed to a ferry terminal outside Dhaka to reach their hometowns as Bangladeshi authorities have announced a strict coronavirus lockdown, which will come into effect from Thursday. Officials have, however, not said when the measures would end.
People in Bangladesh on Monday rushed to the Mawa ferry terminal about 40 kilometers outside of the capital Dhaka ahead of a strict coronavirus lockdown set to come into effect on Thursday. The lockdown announcement sparked an exodus of migrant workers from Dhaka, with tens of thousands cramming into ferries to reach their hometowns, while authorities have suspended all other public transport services connecting the national capital to contain a surge in infections. Offices will be closed and there will be restrictions on movement during the nationwide lockdown, with only essential services and some export-facing factories allowed to operate. Officials have, however, not said when the measures would end.
আমি লকডাউনেতে আপনি সিটিগাং রোডের থেকে পোস্ত খোলা পর্যন্ত গাইটি আইছি কষ্ট আমার ব্যাগনেটা খুব অসুস্থ তার নিয়ে আমি বাড়ি যাচ্ছি লকডাউনে ফেরির অপেক্ষায় বসে আছি
As of Tuesday morning, Bangladesh reported 896,770 confirmed cases of coronavirus and 14,276 deaths. Restrictions on activities and movement were imposed across Bangladesh in mid-April as cases and deaths jumped to their highest levels since the start of the pandemic. Infections declined in May but started to rise again this month, sparking harsher restrictions.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Authorities in Nepal's Kathmandu Valley on Monday decided to reopen public transport service for the first time in 2 months as part of eased COVID-19 restrictions. However, the ongoing lockdown has been extended for one more week till 5th of July.
Authorities in Nepal's Kathmandu Valley on Monday announced the reopening of public transport service for the first time in 2 months as part of eased COVID-19 restrictions, while the lockdown has been extended for one more week till 5th of July. The chief district officers of Kathmandu, Lalitpur and Bhaktapur that are part of the Kathmandu Valley decided to permit public vehicles with at least 25 seats to operate on odd-even basis from 6 a.m. till 7 p.m. Last week, authorities had given permission to private vehicles and taxis to ply based on the odd-even system. Meanwhile, grocery shops will now be allowed to open throughout, while other businesses can operate from 11 a.m. till 6 p.m. This comes as the number of COVID-19 cases has been declining across Nepal. The Himalayan nation as of Tuesday reported 35,310 active cases of coronavirus and death toll stood at 9,071. The Kathmandu region has been under a lockdown since April 29.
With the aim to empower and provide more opportunities, transgender organization in India's Western Maharashtra state has opened a school that provides free education to transgender people. About 25 adults and a few children have been admitted to the school so far.
A transgender organization in India's Western Maharashtra state has opened a school dedicated to transgenders in an initiative to meet the educational requirements of the long persecuted community. Members of the Mahashakti Trust have opened this school in the state's capital, Mumbai, which currently has 25 students to provide free education and uplift the community. Paras Ramjilal Thakur, a transgender teacher at the school, said they want to educate the third gender that still faces discrimination in India.
मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा खुशी है कि ये किन्नर विद्यालय हमारे लिए खुला है क्योंकि ये बहुत ही आश्चर्यजनक चीज हुई हमारे समाज में मतलब पहली बार इतिहास में ये जो सुनाई में आया कि किन्नर विद्यालय जो कि पॉसिबल नहीं था लेकिन आज सुन के और इस जगह पे साथ में काम करके मुझे बहुत खुशी हो रही है
Transgender students who were forced to drop out of educational institutions as they faced bullying expressed their happiness as they are now getting another chance to attend school.
बहुत खुशी मिल रही है कि हम लोग को फिर से मौका मिल रहा है और हम लोग के हमारे किन्नर लोग के साथ में बैठ के मिल रहा है तो और अच्छी बात हो रही है
India's 2011 census recorded 500,000 transgender people, but campaigners estimate the number at about 2 million. Less than half are literate, and even fewer have jobs, according to the census. Traditionally, transgender people in India have been confined to the margins of society.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.